Tá taihinim líon ag na gael ar an imirce gan roa. Ach tá grúpa amáin díob seo gur beag a higamid fúha. Iad fe chelt sa star leis na glúnta, aistrithe in aiga dola 360 bliain ó hin ag Cromwell. Iarsma dearúta atá anta de na polisithe cruálacha a bhí aige in éirin, a chrisa múic le slad ruthadáthe is 1600. Ach, ceir a míle again, marana slucht a gónaí, beobacht a scartha an sel. Con teacht orthu, caithimid féchans leistír den drach sin ar a dugamid pártas. Barbados, Ilan Driachta is Saliacht Noel. Gak Gira, Alien, the meal to air in the gun, or hoar in the grainy, agus rum punch nugo. Chafogarev Rotherle, Dormela Amach.
It's an interesting thing that even today, if you ask somebody, what would you do if you win the lotto, the first place that will come out is Barbados. So Barbados is somewhere in the folk memory here in Ireland. In a way that's unusual. I mean, they'd never say the Seychelles or Jamaica or hundreds of other islands that are 10 times the size of Barbados.
Ach, ma gluish mi de stiachon dragus na hostan, ta eshberis ernach ele erfadroin. Trasnian tranglam de vohrini bioga antilan reig corel sha, tri foroshti tuihe St. James agus St. Thomas, idrona farigi fiaina host de St. John. Tá urthar in a láin a thugann aig ar an Atlantic, corrigach agus gan trócaire. Is anamh a thugann trasóirí éirnacha mach an seo, cé go bhfuil áilacht agus úntas ag bhaint leis. Seo an deangan deiranach ag daoine a bhí scaipe trá ar fud Barbados. Daoine a éteach dá digadí sé, fréamh a sinseir a leanúint a reis go héireann, albain agus urthar hasna, a bhormhór síolruithe ón drama d'aistrigh Cromwell gan trócaire. Agus don miogán chuirtóirí éirnach a chasan leo, tá an aigeanna agus an áhanna an chasúil ó siúd a eicfá sa bhaile.
My family came, they came as slaves, white slaves, that's all I know. They were in the plantations.
People today talking about slavery, the Africans and things, but we also the white people, some of us, was in slavery too.
Back in the years of slavery, they brought the whites here so to work on the plantation, right? But they couldn't really manage the sun. And that's how they, I think that's how they get the name of the Redlegs, right? Because the sun scorched them, like, burned them up.
I don't remember where the lady came from, but I remember she looked at me and she asked me, "You're from Barbados?" I say, "Yes, I was born here," she say. "You know, it's strange, you don't look so, you don't sound like a Bajan." I say, "Well, I can't do anything about that, because I'm a Bajan by birth."
Pobl darn huelta as Éirin, bio bocht fe grian na Caribe. Ach, cén fá nach fil níos mó ólis a gwingarha?
Well, the story goes, Bogan Tishkin, Eg Munchen Heron, Imurka, River Gortamore. Higmund Goma, Kerdaharla, and Yen Gortamore, Ak Rivishin, Vinicatamila, Ernak, a Gimokdas and Tearshaw. Sinshakdo Easteg, Dimic Nicatamila, Hardar, as and Tearshaw. Kodjakob Marsaiduri, Kodjelamar Shervishi, Ak Kodjismog a better Marslavaha.
You're taught to a kind friend, Kangal, area, and quit shot and down. Taught to kind for Shrohan exulia, August excessive to fear this in a Shrohanishin, to Tavokt and class system and Akma, August unpointed and snap, Mion and Colunatus. the savage world of the colonizer.
Dem Lena Ohin, Vian Green Graffador Erinok, Sheena Jolly, Eg Ober Iskol in Irhard Barbados. Sprag on Pobble Ferun Shin E, Ledol Eg Fisru Fuha, Ogson Maid Achonixi a Hafada.
I first met the Redlegs because I was living in Barbados and working there. I knew of their existence because people talked about them, and occasionally I'd see them walking along the road barefooted, obviously very poor, and hauling coconuts up the hill in Newcastle in St. John. And initially I went in, they were quite suspicious of me, but I was on my own, I was female, and I had worked there, so they allowed me to talk to them, and the more time I spent with them, the more I got to know them. I knew that their ancestors came from Scotland and Ireland. When I talked to Bajan friends, they really knew very little about the current population, the poor whites that have been left behind, basically.
Shetia quig a coig nailing Avrasak or Quiradini Oscarios as near Gadian Caribbean, near Honish Shidana, Quirogia, the Togogas, and Art Feneid. It's victims of the dispossession. Tá corsiastiante mi dearafor séite cuig a cuig.
I stólam nachra mar an ólas ar an ábhar sin, agus nach mi an starí na héran ag caint fwy gomór. Níl sé múnha sna hólscoil nó na scolina gomínic.
In a lán slite, is at an rodeg will kinne gyal bio bocht in Marmedos oid le kerkhead blien in a gilean an cricken gyal an rachmas agoni. O hus na shachtu isha deag, fuin se untuk severish agus kochta a visa charib, agus moran cholinic di elis a daungan nua, da vuur kochta I tashgaliachta na horpa, gaharaha na Francig, Olonig, Spanig agus Sassanig. Honig na céad coolínithe go Barbados is séideag fithe chuig, taiscéalathe agus cion rudathe ar thóir an rachmas le gohátas beaga talún ag fás tabach agus cadás, sasanig a ba a bhormhór.
An dús sin é ó 2016 ar aig, de bhí spéis ag flandóirí gaelach chun flandálathe chuir ar bán imar Barbados. Agus de bhí géir gá le Sharabhóntsí mar ní rahéon loch séthir ar fáil in sna hiáin ag an puinte sin ar chorbe.
Thnig na hhéannig go asach mar thuhíiseigh, a chus níidir ag teacht mar sclábhathe taréis de Oliver Cromwell a naide is sasna agus an Alban na cheansú agus a áard a dhiú ar éan. Idir séidir dachané agus séidir chuigadó. Chail éirn breisis láth dá déanra, cuid faoin chliabh, cuid eile faoi pholasaí a bhí úsáid a go hanéfachta cé Cromwell in áitina eile, aistrú chuig na colíneachtaí.
Tá galar, tá cuga in éirn ag an dréibhse sin, agus tá gúrta mór ann freisin. Tá cosúltocht ar an scéal gúil gá cinnal daoine curtha go dtí Barbados sa dréibhse sin. I dús póire, tá muid a caint faoi daoine bochta an loch déirce daoine nach bhfuil áit cónaithe acu. Na daoine eile a chur thar lár ná na daoine a feiciú mar contúirteach don stáit.
Cromwell decided that what he was basically going to do was send those Irish that he deemed the most troublesome to the Caribbean.
Come on!
His initial policy had been to push Irish Catholics off their land and into the province of Connacht. When some didn't follow that kind of persuasion, I suppose, or those who were continuing to cause trouble for the English were shipped out across the ocean.
Agustavi mná agus páistí I gceist chomh le iarsaid dúirí ina measc ach Sharabhóntsí a bhí I gceist ansin agus Sharabhóntsí a chur gur fáil do sna flandóirí sasanach a bhí bhaim ar I gcéantúsaíocht siúcra a bhí ar siúla I Marbédos ag an tam sin.
Begin den a hérinig astrahe dín tuara hínu, ag díala cuidibre le plandálaha sa daunua ar fa akar ardaha ama. Ag derin a trefse sin da maradís bio, vi gawaltas talun gealtadoif. Nír viú tránín na dín tuara sin áfach, níl Barbados ach lach chomór le chunt elu, agus vi an talava vi le brona ag na sasnig ag derin a gonarhi ibre, chanafeint hocha agus barri luach for a corta an.
Vidini an Noroling, Vidini an Arin Brabach, Gossam Roda Vir Schulter and Colinicus, Vidini an Agus Vidaran Mar Sorts Glova, Nain Dinchard Servants, Vian Erevin Rawaka, Vidrisul and Alman Tabak, Mia Coop, Puntiag Beden, Upisatal and Aka, Rodnar Fushed.
Credem Golcha Intuk Tavok, the Dikokti in the Chaos of Danic Sheet. As a mud in an impact in Mahurim, Yarshid on Kangal, no on Dokus, no on Irakt, if you on Tishkin to be a Nadinian, a Cassadonador. My creditor Grosha Antavador, Nakdikok Nadina, Gro Shan Kultur, Gro Shan Tradition, a Bind Lahub, Agas in Yala Shin, Nakmechid Akmar Sklav, a Machinshaw.
Nirawain Conra, either the Slavio Africa. Nirawen kartana egna slavi shin ar kurbe, de vi shit kangelta gudji ura wash, o de evan khunra either sharavon shas and chirsha marhample, de vi share fat triblina no kerablina no shachtumlina, agus again printishin, de vi sersha akab fin de li. Agus ig fekunder and scale fes or a vishay marvedos, de vi on forvor di of maravigan quinta shin or be an sersha vicart kemi of sershak of tushkarashi ko naflon tul shin
kumati na jorda ha shakal fwindek ashtar awar any either ocht agaste shachtani vina kunilaka kohulkshin gur kailagalanaka a vad sulur hrisadar an karib Il kuntas arbe an shli in ar chana tradalaha lena lastas ernach, ag ta isigwing cadavi rompa na rehrisadar an talan, a vuiachas shin le Richard Ligon a dailsig a true and exact history of the island of Barbados is shedir quaiga shacht. Ta an talav Fred Smith o Ullscoil William and Mary, Virginia, I mon tochalta shandaliach in Barbados. Tá sé ag oberlen na Vicléin chun tuiscint a áil ar na tuairiscí i leabhar Richard Ligon a chuir an síos ar an mealach in ar thuis na hÉireann an Tiláin agus mar a bhí orthu a nídan féin a thógáil.
Upon the arrival of any ship, the planters go aboard and having bought such of them as they like, send them with a guide to his plantation and being come, commands them instantly to make their cabins, which they not knowing how to do, are to be advised by other of their servants that are their seniors. But if they be churlish and will not show them, or if material be wanting to make them cabins, then they are to lie on the ground that night. These cabins are to be made of sticks with some plantain leaves under some little shade that may keep the rain off. Their suppers being a few potatoes and water and mobby for drink, the next day they are rung out with a bell to work at 6 o'clock in the morning, till the bell ring again, which is 11 o'clock, and then they return and are set to dinner, either with a mess of loblolly, bonavist, or potatoes.
The rare stara na linge, nor hoctí na hérinne gastrhe os na longa a desach, fiúctí an dram a barasta, agus díluc na conarhi. Dearug mar a yenfi le sclavahe on Afric, cegur ef na hernig in anam, is cosant egan a vecho mar hervisig din tiurahe. Agus biac is gur ef an caidan didan agus bia an isildoiv, va vasa fos an scelacha, da mrishadish an real balu. Here in the shade of Quagadi, we have a meal to Ernach Astrahe on Eroid Vogue Tushkart Nahorpe, Gachas Marafach Nivnak Barbados. Kegorev quid biogdi veg Arnoil on quid arigid, trive eg unvaru shukre rashgudi and vratin, via vorvor signahe in Ifrin Elan Barbados gandochus.
This island is the dunghill whereon England doth cast forth its rubbish. Rogues and whores and such like people are those which are generally brought here in the most unsupportable captivity, grinding at the mills, attending the furnaces, or digging in the scorching island, having nothing to feed on but potato roots. Bought and sold from one planter to another, or attached as horses and beasts for the debts of their masters, being whipped at the whipping posts as rogues for their master's pleasure.
The Africans are accustomed to the climate. These people were not. That is why bond servants didn't really last in Barbados, because they died off too quickly. Furthermore, if you only have the use of a bond servant for 5 or 6 years, you got everything you can out of him. If you have a slave, you have him for life. So you're likely to pay more attention to him. That doesn't mean the blacks didn't suffer. They suffered a lot.
I have seen an overseer beat a servant with a cane about the head till the blood has followed, for a fault that is not worth the speaking of. Truly, I have seen such cruelty there done to servants as I did not think one Christian could have done to another.
Tagan Sheikhlun Diag, the winter and Olive Carl Watson and Marbados, as Aaron, the Roastig or Horkig, a Bayeder Dus. She should prive study an Elan, or Hursi on Hine Yalvocht.
It didn't matter if you were an indentured servant or a slave. If you were subjected to a severe whipping, the whip cracked equally severely on a white back, just as it did on a black back. They were treated equally horrifically and suffered equal horrific punishments.
Macahag co holkshin lesh na milte erdnig se shachtu hishteag. Conas marshin, nafwil ein koramak egdini erin shkel in erin in yuv.
Well, history has two levels. History seen from above, from the point of view of the powerful, and history seen from below. And usually those from below were either illiterate and hence left no written records of their daily lives or their experiences. It was as if, well, they were there, but they did not exist. So they would be proverbial invisible people of the 17th century.
Is anav a agan the buicht, fianaise a sail in a nig. Scobin sperlingi con siúle, agus glanan lucht an rachmish amachas an staré godeo. Tá Fred Smith agus a Vic Lane hór ein inise ar gnáshail le húl na tréna jarúta seo. Is léir gur a bhsail an chine gheal vocht an chosúl le sail na sclávathe gormas na léhanta tosig, ac ma seachas cine a ba an difríocht. Ní mór tochalt godáin san áid even seo con finise a áil ar chrótan.
The archaeological work that we've been doing here has been focused on trying to get a general sense of plantation life. And here at St. Nicholas Abbey, there seems to be a preponderance of bowl forms and a greater emphasis on bowls than on flatware plates. And this probably reflects the emphasis on stewed foods, whereas the planter's house has a great deal more flatware associated probably with roasts and other types of foods.
De na Redlegs Erdnacha na Belti Suracha Kena lish na Sklava Hagorma. Beska das na Plandala ha Sevra, Kedfi a Lochdibra a Chansu, Leshach Harga Flurshach, a Hanagon Brussel Shukra, Rum.
Rum today is the second most widely consumed alcoholic beverage in the world. But in the 17th century and the 18th century, it was really a drink of enslaved peoples, of poor whites, indentured servants, of seamen. Life was very challenging, especially the disease environment in early Barbados, in which many people were dying from a variety of tropical diseases, hurricanes, earthquakes, a difficult place to live, especially if you were poor or enslaved. And so rum really kind of helped meet the challenges of daily life in Barbados and provided a temporary escape.
Scríobh Coilíneach Lua Amháin Gnéine Athair.
To send out 50 cases of good spirit and make no question than that you will have great gains from them. They are generally such drunkards on this island that they will find coppers to buy their drinks, although they go without themselves. I have seen, upon the Sabbath day as I have been walking to church, first one, presently another, lying in the highway so drunk that there be land crabs that have bit off some of their fingers, some of their toes, and have killed some before they have wakened.
They drank heavily. In fact, that was a common feature among these whites. You know, they consumed vast quantities of alcohol. So obviously that would have had some effect on the overall health, you know, many, many years later.
It was logical for the people of the time to conclude that overconsumption of rum led to this laziness and this inability to work hard, and the whole pejorative stereotype that developed associated with poor whites. But actually there are medical reasons that explain some of the debilities. A large percentage of the poor whites of Barbados who were too poor to have shoes, and so who worked bare feet in their fields, etc., picked up parasitic infections, particularly hookworm infections. And somebody with masses of hookworms in the body wouldn't be able to respond well to situations, would stumble, slouch, move very slowly, and be seen sort of like the village idiot.
Enslaved Africans who didn't drink as much as the poor whites, they had family networks. They had large communities of people that could work together, and sort of community networks that would help ease the challenges of everyday life. Whereas poor whites tended to live sort of in the outskirts of communities, very little opportunities for upward mobilities, and as a result, sort of lost themselves in drinking.
Part of the issue was that the whites remained by themselves. And so you had a situation where there was quite a bit of intermarrying. They would have had quite a lot of families marrying each other, first or second cousins marrying each other. It was frowned upon for a white female to marry a black guy. So they married predominantly white men. And of course, the whole issue of incest. I mean, it's not a nice thing to speak about, but that obviously happened in those type of communities.
If one looks very quickly at the demographic patterns and racial patterns of Barbados over time, Barbados started as a white majority colony, but by the 1660s, it had become a black majority, where about 60% of the population was black and 40% was white. And what they did with this large poor white population on the island was they used it as a buffer group between themselves and the black slave population. And during the period of slavery, the poor white population was critical to the status and success and, if you like, peace of mind of the planter class.
1640s, you might have had maybe 4,000 or 5,000 black slaves, but by 1660 you had about 60,000 slaves, and the population moved down to about 10,000 whites and 60,000 blacks. So they needed to have some form of militia or military for internal security. And the laws were made that for every 30 acres of land you had to have one able-bodied white man to serve in the militia.
Kinshad vi dini bane tastal kon ord agus agar akamad agus kungamak iluent akabi gursi vilata kinshasa vi gwine ein airiamak mar de vi chine an fachis vi akab gani gan airiak na slavia mak in a quinab.
ach bíad na hirnig in Barbados an dram dernach go mbeag muinéinig sasna gasta. Bhí sasna puritánach agus protestúnach ba chatlacaigh na hirnig, bhí cáil orthu mar gaoine a bhí agóní réig le hÁirí i gcoinne a maistrí.
Bhí na Spáinnig agus na Francaigh congrach go leor do na hoileáin seo, agus faoi cinnte go raibh atias ar an údaras na hoileáin gimach na hÉireannaigh a bhí ann gimach siad sásta córéitú a dhéanamh leis na Francaigh agus leis na Spáinnig inionad an pobal sasnach a bhí ann.
Beidir ábhras ar na húdaráis sin mar hapla tuiscar ag na hÉireannaigh agus bhíidir mar móraibh ag 1768 deag go raibh ar Catholicigh agus gomála sin ceapán go raibh ar bald an Franc mar hapla. So I gcónaí bhí na húdaráis sin smaga London a bhíidir ábhras an faoin na hÉireannaigh.
Is cinnte tá scéalta ann gur tháinig sagart go dtí Barbados agus chur amhaith iad go Scopaí. Mar bhí fatias ar an údaras gimach siad in ann an féinúlacht catalachach sin na chothú.
Le cosc ortha a gredamh a chleachta ní raibh fágha de clú ar na hÉireannaigh seo ach a gomas chun tribhlóide.
Indeed, sales of plantations and mortgages and so on, where the white servants are listed by name because they're party property. You'll find John Maguire and in brackets Irish. They were expected to give trouble.
Monaster St. Nicholas an Chuck Plandala is Shinna Erdanilan. Ten Shashir. Go séidir chuig a thucht. Go dtí beagnach nédíag dahad rinneach siúcra agus roma thoracha an le haig asportála agus déanfar a ríis. Cheannig Larry Warren, altar de bhunna an chinnighealmhacht St. Nicholas chun gnóthas leantach a dhéanamhas, ach freisin mar lí le hamás a thuairt tas na glúnta idir cheal agus gorm do bhaointear Barbados.
That mill is an embodiment of St. Nicholas because at one stage in Barbados, there were 110 or more of those mills in the island, and that's the last remaining one. Just by fate, it was preserved. But that mill was really destined to be scrapped, and then Colonel Cave, who was the owner here, and someone with the Canadian government got together and they preserved it and brought it here. In many respects, a lot of the people that do go to Barbados feel so comfortable there, they just don't go beyond to know the history of Barbados. Of course, since owning St. Nicholas, I've read books on it and quite amazed at the period around 1650 and Oliver Cromwell and how he, in fact, transported all of these poor Irish people here to become slaves and, in fact, were treated as bad or even worse, you know.
Débrig Winston Gill, mar bhair seor, a Monaster St. Nicholas, le truc a bliain.
To most black people, they think they were the only ones that were in slavery. But to some person who understand and know history is that all two races was in slavery, the white and the black. And the white was the first slave in Barbados. But in the 17th century, a lot of the white people that were doing manual labor on the estates were driven off in preference to black, because their production was not as great as the black. So then they went on to, some went on to America, some went on to other Caribbean islands. Well, the ones that stayed still continued to weather the storm on the island. The white people were mainly centered around Bath and St. John, Churchill, and that area.
Ach, ken obair a bhí ann dos na hÉireannaigh bhochta seo a bhí gan sealuchas ná dóchas.
The women of the militia tenants also earned some money because, of course, each plantation had the contractual or economic responsibility to supply clothes, etc., for the slave population. And so many of these white women were employed as seamstresses, etc.
Buine na bochtáin fóir as gach éanrad, mar a fuair Fred Smith amach, i gcrúdaithe teaghlach bhilisteach.
Here you can see even better the coral rubble construction techniques that were used building these houses. These were just coral rubble that were picked up from the ground, surrounding bedrock, pieced together using a lime plaster mortar that would sort of bake the limestone, get it into a powdery form, add water, and that would be the basis for sort of concrete in those days. And it's very strong construction technique, as you can see. Perhaps the most interesting finds were these tiny pieces of ceramic that had been whittled down into what are gaming pieces. These were probably used for chess or for backgammon. We've also found a large number of buttons, which suggests that perhaps somebody at some time at this house may have been a seamstress or a tailor.
Derrick and Skilnius Massa don Chinegal Vocht Ashtakalur in the Fuskilte Octiog Trukakar. Bisclavaha are in the Printishak the Abel de Adahi Augusta Skilina Ashtrugri and Margaser, Nirev Nishkilina Shin Egna Redlegs, Augustarian Homa, Nirev Faunorha, Oberienov, a Holyader Leshna Sclavaha Gorma. Vrahader Eid Fain Nias Kosuli Leshna Plondala Hisevra, Dram Nakrev Simdaliadaka Unta.
During slavery, the slaves were not supposed to do anything that's skilled. But of course, they were skilled carpenters or did all sorts of skilled work, but they weren't supposed to. At emancipation, the blacks were able to do anything they wanted. And the poor whites had a very rough time.
Almost immediately at emancipation, the plantation owners said, "We no longer need militia tenants. The freed people will no longer receive clothing from us. And so we don't need these white seamstresses anymore to produce this clothing." And they just ordered them off the plantation.
Curha Azide, Begin des Nadini Gyala Bochta, Maractand Sna Chattel Houses, Maramirkna Sklavaha. Dead fina tiha aimed Serdasha, Nak Viter Arthur Be Achemar Bedos, a Ashtru of Flondalamon, Gaplondalele, Agus Nahibrehe, Hor Ibra Avigan.
They would walk half over the island to demand alms, or depend for their subsistence on the charity of slaves. Yet they are as proud as Lucifer himself, and in virtue of their freckled ditchwater faces, consider themselves on a level with every gentleman in the island.
Ach, near on Gach Redlake Bucht, Tá Richard Goddard, a rinne de Nadini Gno is Severa in Barbados, agus an vroduul gojo as a Irish Redlake. Hugh Lehiana her cosnock the stjach savalumor, duskal shupperum, agus hog imperact. Akshir, son Octu Ishteog, Kamadan Gra, Egdinadar Hinshir, the Colin Gaelic, Darabanim, Margaret Mahan, Winter Goddard Bucht, or Fagna Kienta.
We can't find anything about her, but from her name, we suspect that she was Roman Catholic and Irish. And at those times, they were bringing Irish women over here as partners for the planters, never looked down as the lower castes, if I can use that word. And that was the way he marries the woman, and Goddard then is read out of the family fortune. This photograph of nine fishermen on Bath Beach was taken about 1908. They were black and white fishermen. And the one on the back row to the right is Thomas Henry Goddard, and that would be my grandfather's uncle. And you'll notice that they're all wearing crocus bags, which is a jute bag, where head and shoulders were cut out. And they were all barefooted. There's a bottle of rum on the ground, which I suspect that they were probably bribed to stand still for the photograph. And I remember my brother-in-law telling me that once he asked my grandfather, who was now in his 80s, "Mr. Joe, tell me about the good old days when you were a boy." And my grandfather started to cry. And he said, "No, Dennis, they were not good days. I wouldn't wish them on my worst enemy. I knew what it was like to be hungry, sick, no job, no opportunity, and all those good days." In 1834, when the police force was formed and the military tenants really were then put off the land, they weren't needed any longer. And these people who had been on those as military tenants for probably 150 years.
Chuig a bhórbhór chun chóna faoi ailte Hackleton, áit a raibh an talamh cóthalc sin go raibh an cíos an íseal. Chun stac mór so síolta agus fisiciúil ba é chóna faoi na hailte sin. Bhí trí áit ina bhéadach na bochtáin bána drapa suas, thugtaí Monkey Jump ar ceann de na pointí ba dheacradaíomh.
Over there to my right, where those coconut trees are, is the base of Monkey Jump. It would come up probably about 200 yards. You have to come on all fours, and then at times in crop, you would carry cane on your head, probably bundles of eight canes, probably weighed 40 or 50 pounds, and you got $1.44 or 6 shillings for a ton of cane. They were living here because that's where land was cheapest. It was very rocky. It was not suitable for cultivation for the plantations, and they would pay about $8 per acre per year rent. But down here, you really got it for $4. It was just so bad, it just didn't produce. You had to plant among the stones to get some form of a crop. It was extremely hard. I don't think that many of them knew much about their forebears. They knew they'd come from Scotland or Ireland. Their little world, even to go to town, some people had lived their whole life here and never been to Bridgetown.
Bioganin har fihe mile o Bridgetown ta a slucht fosan eg marachtail ar an gaelchid. An traf ernach as mo gwyl jarud deant arra. Ac, chanas taan seilach o anish dairire. Tá aithne ag an grianghrafadóir Sina Jolly ar na Redlegs in Martin's Bay le blianta. Anois, tá sí ar ais ag glacadh pictúrí den phobal seo atá ag dul a liad.
The poor whites have been suppressed since the 17th century. They were looked down upon by the blacks and by their better off whites. That hadn't changed in 2000. I'm pleased to say that since I've come back 8 years later, I think there's a huge change there. And I think before there was very little integration between the blacks and the whites. When I photographed Earline Downey in 2000, she actually lived in a stone house, but there was no running water, no electricity. And once a week she boiled water to wash herself. Life was hard. She was collecting coconuts, splitting the husks and selling those to a nursery to grow orchids. She was in her 70s, she was very fit. So it was interesting for me to re-photograph her. Perhaps her life was easier in some ways, but her living circumstances were dreadful. They were worse. But she was still happy. In spite of all that adversity, she was still smiling, still telling jokes.
When I come along, I point all the family living here. But you all ancestors come from overseas. I only know my great-grandmother. I only hear a bit from her, that how her parents come from these islands and so, you know.
Drafúracha iad Joyce agus Nita le Earline Downey a warren freshen i Chattel House in Martin's Bay.
I love my fishing. Funny amateurs, funny rocks, and his throat are lying. And just starts up my line to catch my fish. I keep my fish for me to eat.
And especially at night when the sea draw. I get a lantern and I go in the sea and catch lobsters too. Right, sir.
I want to break
ropes. My lady, there's a stick up there and a knife up there.
Tá gealach ar mallartaithe a bhaim ag na Redlegs, tachaí an gachéin le na chéile, bahí an cuidacha mocha, fás an cuidéile breadfruit, déan an cuidacha íascach fós, atarha mar an siad mar éanad mar phobal.
In my years gone by, I never thought of nothing, so. You know, like our roots and things, we never say like where we really away from.
That's why hiding your roots.
Because like your grandparents or your parents never sit down, right? And like you would try to form a conversation and tell them, ask them a certain question like which part your parents are away from, you know? Myself. All of them say themself. You know what I'm saying? So we can't go no more. We can't ask no more.
All the youngsters nowadays, just looking at you and saying, oh, you was this and that. Just get to know you first and then make a judgment.
You still got a lot of racism here, though, because first thing you stab up your skin and thing. And you know, like, they try to keep you down and things like that. For years gone by, you know, like slavery days and all that kind of foolishness, that staying out that we is who the boy that
caused slavery.
Caused them to be slaves and things, you know. Instead, try to keep it down, you think.
But I just have one thing to tell them. I just asked them where I was born 400 years ago. I don't know about slavery. I come into free next.
My name is Eustace Norris. Well, I understand from my old parents, my family came as slaves, white slaves. That's all I know. They were in the plantations. My old grandfather, they were in the land. They were in the land, my father were in the land, in the factory making sugar. Well, they had to put them on the shelter because of good sandy heat. I work in a plantation at overseers. I ride the fields and do the books, you know. What I love about it, we're born here. I'm born here, so this is my little island.
I understand my family came here by slave ship. And they was working as slaves, and then from there, they went on, you know, the skin can take the sun. So they had colored people then came in. But all my family, from the time I was growing up, was with the land. They worked the land, they prepared food, but I never went to the supermarkets and things for everything they want to eat. They grow it yourself. I go to St. Margaret's Church. I was church at St. John sometimes. Or sometimes I go to different religion. I don't keep one religion. I keep everybody that connect with the Almighty.
My life story, as far as I can remember, I born in a place such as like a jungle, the woods, crept on all woods. And my father and mother was pretty poor. Raised up in a small 18 by 10 wooden house, which we call a charter house. When I was a youngster, I used to go into St. Clifton Hall, potato ground, after the dig and sell the potato, and I had sprouts coming up. I used to go and help dig some, and but you was hungry, parents unable to feed you. I had to eat some of them raw, and you had to eat them kind of things to survive. But the little education I did get, I got it by trying to read newspapers and comic books, and then I started to get education, and then by working a cash machine, giving back change and different things like that, I got the little education I have. But I just relax at home now, joined a little pension from the government. It ain't a big lot, but it would shake the puppy tail from out the ashes.
And the Irish diaspora is seen as a real part of our national wealth, a national asset, if you want to use that phrase. I think that there could be significant benefits in Ireland and Barbados, getting to know each other better and resurfacing the connections that are actually there. I mean, there are people in the United States who would probably claim Irish passports, certainly say they're Irish, and they wouldn't be as closely connected to Ireland as many Bajans would be.
The Denny, Ta Kangala Yenov Egdini Arash in Erin Lenangwelta Sakarab, Vian Tahir Jim Finn, August David Shirley, Partagan Rupa Heen Lava Mock and Winter Vok Barbados, August Vrad David, Nor August Kangala Cromwell, Ain Roa Elege.
The Countess of Huntington was Lady Shirley, and some of the Shirleys had come to Ireland with Cromwell. And then when I started to hear the story of Barbados and some of the atrocities that were committed there, that really stirred my heart.
That's her husband.
I can't undo what was done 350 years ago, but I can stop something of that repeating itself into the future.
I felt here were people really that had been forgotten. Here were people who were on the margins of society and were at the bottom rung of society. And then when I kind of read the piece of history, how they were rounded up and brought out there and what had happened to them, I felt that we needed to redeem the situation. We needed to inform them who they were.
On the picture there, you see me with an Irish flag because of the people that died without an Irish identity, that died without an identity, any identity. If you see the difference between St. John's Church and St. Margaret's Church, the gravestones there, they were absolute monuments in comparison to the little wooden crosses that were rotting away down in the other place. And you could see how they were able to put value on their people and remember them, but then the poor people, there was no value put on them.
A pedigal spirit ta intak tavuk ta anka sola spirit mint in the heron. Inyal an andro an drohide agus na fibhe ni mór a bhí Jacob gar airlo maractáil tan spirit sin láidir mas na dhéine sin fósam húram se.
Cate i dír ag an stair is beag dout ná gur héad gréithe trádála an Atlantic slucht na nairan na chastra histéin is teach a bhásach chultúrtha ar fá gáchéad blian nú níos mó. The Hrumlach and Denra Gordon Bejan is Pobble Type Shuliet in the Redlegs. Is Biogatar Olasako, Fina Gorsen Yala, Agus Fwak, Fina Scale Nav Gnach. Ma Captor O Omgokele, Gotorosori, Arsira Olakon Eid in the Redlegs, Winan Quid the Milan Lenishinshir, Avisas the Kina Aronu Har Akma, O Hevna Fenulach today. Nienhik on Gluan Nua on Botun Kena. Tigan siad gur sais córá i de chuoine agus ahrú a bhúnlíon fír féinúlacht. Tá garfáistí ar sin seir tuiltanach san lá atá nuhán, bheith ar an bán chéanna mar thránnig Barbados le chuile dram eile ar an Ilán áling seo.
Black or white, we're all one. And I don't think colour should really be a discrimination. The gentleman there, Herbert, the Brunskin guy, we were married November, it's 40 years. At first, some of my family from my father's side, they didn't like the idea of me getting married to him. But I had to let them know it is me. And I think if it is my happiness, then it should be okay. And so far, no regrets. Well, my oldest granddaughter, and she's heading on to university. But all she's telling me is, Granny, not to worry. One good day, you're going to be out of this. I'm going to help you. That's all she's telling me. That's my oldest grand. And I'm very proud of her. And I feel good, that's for sure. I don't mind what people think. I feel good. And I feel proud of who I am.